Good afternoon, everyone. I, Avika Rupendra Kumar Jain, student manager, Balaji Institute of International Business, hereby takes the proud privilege to introduce Mr. Harish Nandwani. Mr. Harish Nandwani is an MBA, Human Resources from Institute of Management and Research. He is a Vice President, Human Resource at Tata Auto Component Systems Limited. Sir has over 25 years of professional experience in the field of human resource management, currently working for one of the largest engineering company as Vice President, Human Resources. He has been handling challenging assignments related to recruitment, performance management, training, and employee development and compensation design, and has performed roles of a change agent, mentor, performance analyst, and motivator, and has strong exposure to key HR and personnel functions in pharma, chemical, FMCG, and engineering domains. As Vice President, Human Resource, Tata Auto Component System Limited, sir, management process, culture building, strategic HR management, business review, organization capability building processes, organization health surveys, manager quality life, career development, organization development, employees engagement framework, innovation, HR policies designing and implementation. Sir has also been associated with ASB International, Japanese MNC, as General Manager, Human Resources, and with ASIL Propact Limited, Mumbai, as Head Senior Manager, Human Resources. ASIL Propact is the world's largest...
Just to cut it short.
Yeah.
Otherwise, time will go.
Fine. Sir has been awarded as Best HR Professional in the Western India Indra Super Achiever Award 2009. Sir, the podium is all yours. Thank you.
I don't know where to start. Because I believe my time was between 12:30 to 1:30, right? I don't have any regret, you know. I'm also a student of T.V. Rao. So I'm really thankful to the Balaji. Those have given me opportunity to listen to him after a long time. So I don't have any regret to have that time spent here, but only I could see very hungry faces here. Yeah. And it has made my job very, very difficult to hold you people here. But definitely, I will not talk as much as she has spoke about my introduction. The other difficulty is that just now, if I could compare two suites, you have just tested, you have just listened a best, the management guru of India, and after that, a poor guy is standing in front of you. It's very, very difficult. It's made my job very difficult to speak anything. In fact, whatever I have prepared, I thought that I will talk about, I really forgot everything. And one more comparison, you have just tested a very, delicious jalebi, which is very sweet. Now you have a very small burfi. So I don't know whether you like the taste of burfi, and it makes my job very much difficult to generate that taste in terms of knowledge sharing. Well, I will not hold you for a long time, at least not for an hour, but certainly, since I've been given this job to share my experience with you and make some kind of value addition, if possible. Well, though I was having a presentation, I have set up everything for an hour or so, or more than 1 hour. But now I will not touch upon, I will pick up the good things which we have just captured. You see, my own personal experience today is that two things which very precise in the presentation made by professor. One is that drive for result, and another was for teamwork. And my personal experience in present scenario is that you may be excellent performer. Today, being a corporate or being a HR head of a company, I give value to the individual credentials and individual potential. But the biggest thing, when I go for the recruitment, I see a person, whether he will get along with the people and share his knowledge and make good team. So my today's priority, first thing, yes, if there is no drive, then you are at a dead wood. And nobody wants to have a dead wood. So certainly drive for result is the first criteria which we would like to see in every person. But he may be excellent, competent, and very knowledgeable. But as he has that aptitude to work along with people, as professor has already touched upon many times, that he has seen people with high head. Today, the success story is not the individual success of anybody. And the current example is our Indian team. Earlier in old Indian time, there was only Sunil Gavaskar, there's only a Vishwanath, there was only few players, the entire team were depending on the one or two players' performance. Today we have a batting line up to 8 number. Even our 8 number batsmen can come and hit as fast as possible or required. So today is the success depends on the how you can contribute to the team as an individual and how you can get along with the team. That is the message which goes along with the presentation which was shared by Professor Rao. How many have heard Stephen Covey? Yeah? Yes, he is one of the best management guru. And there was two principles he always spoke, and his books and his lectures were more focusing on two things. One is the 1910 principle, and other was first thing first. The 1910 principle, what I'm going to talk about is the basics. I'm not going to talk to you the management jargon, a funda, HR funda or management funda, but I'm going to share with you a basic things which has made me successful. And I have seen these people, those are having this learnings in their life. I've seen them successful in their career. What this 90-10 principle talks about is that what happens to you most of the time is not in your control. You may go for a flight, you may be on time, but what is the guarantee that flight will be on time? You may be nice to a person, but what is the guarantee he will be also equally nice to you? There's no guarantee. So how to deal with? Because this is everyday's business. You will come from morning to evening, hundreds of such situations where you don't have the control on others' reaction, others' actions, or anything else which is happening to you. What is in your hand is your own action. How you deal with, that is the only E10 principle. It's a very, very basic and very simple to understand, but very, very difficult to adopt and practice and practice and practice. Before we go for the presentation, I want to ask you one question. How many of people here think that somebody else is responsible for their motivation? Who's responsible for your motivation? Pardon? Good. Let me tell you, if you can't motivate yourself, nobody in the world can motivate you. Because that is the basics. And we always keep saying that my boss is not motivating me, my teachers are not motivating me, my parents are not encouraging me. Because you don't want to get motivated. If you want to get motivated, the result will be the same what Professor Rao has differentiated in two people. It was only the self-motivation. Both these people were doing the same job in different companies, and one has made difference and other was not enjoying his job. So it was only a mindset, and how you deal with that situation makes difference. That is the way this, when our car broke down because of this any situation or because of the any reason, we really don't have the control. But how we react, how we get disappointed, or whether we should manage the other alternative, look for the other alternative and make the job, or manage the job which we were managing at that point of time. So 90% is beyond our control. And we have a control over on 10%. And that is how is what that is what is in our hand. How to react to those situations. You curse on the person serving tea, you get angry, you shout, you spoil your mood, you spoil others' mood. It's a very easy example. Ultimately, you got late, you have spoiled your happiness, your mood, and others too. And why? Only because how you react to in a simple situation. And what would happen if you would have controlled your 10%, that 90% is happened which was not in your hand. So we are the cause. So what you have reacted has ultimately resulted. Now this is another way of controlling the situation, same situation. You have counseled her, you have made her happy. Now you see the difference between two approaches. Both the same situation, only the way we have reacted was different. The same situation. I believe we all got the principle right. I don't want to continue since we have proven the point that it makes only difference how you react. What will happen to you is really not in your control, but how you react to that situation is in your control. And that solves a lot of problem in our personal life as well as in our professional life. You can't really control your boss, but you can control your reaction to his shouting or his arguments or his approach towards you. I would like to invite 4 or 5 people here. Anybody. Because I don't want to have a one-way interaction. Any 5 people, please come here. Yeah, two is enough. 2 or 3 is enough. No problem. Yes, the purpose of calling you know, these people here to have a more interaction rather than you will keep watching the, you know, time and when this session will complete. So I would like to engage you in this interaction. Many of us go for the different business units, and I just seen people have visited 150 units, business units, and so on. You see, I want to create a live story. Suppose you are selected in a company here, right? Today I join in a company. Now we need to interact. Since you people are my new team members, and I would like to, and you are from very good business school, I would like to see how's your thought process and what you think. And you are just completed your induction, so you know what about this company, good and bad also, right? So I would like to engage you in this conversation. If you need to make this company is the best place to work, what would be your suggestion?
So changes will be brought in the company.
What changes?
Maybe there must be a change in the working time.
Yeah, the work should be of teamwork. Teamwork should be given more importance. Mm-hmm. The project should be given in a team, a group. And the appreciation should be given in a group, not a particular person.
Okay.
I think we should have a friendly environment so that we are very comfortable to work there and enjoy our work.
Okay.
And sir, the higher level authorities should also be involved with the employees so mm-hmm. that they are more comfortable and they can more explore in their work.
You see, before, please give them the attention, because they are just stating what they are looking for from their next employment. In that conversation, it is coming out very easily what they are looking from their next employment. Yeah, please go on.
And according to the work, there should be proper recognition.
Okay. So teamwork, communication, empowerment. Yeah.
I shall complete my work at time and looking for new tasks.
Pardon, please come again.
I shall complete my job at time and looking for new tasks.
So you are talking about balance between personal and professional life, right? What else you would like to say?
Sir, according to you, we have induction, so we know what is going on and uh-huh. what is not. So if there needs to be any change, we should inform the we should have suggestion that we can inform our immediate supervisor, whichever.
So you are saying that people should be involved in suggestion making.
Yes.
Okay, great. You see, these are the quality which when we are into the business school, we are just passing out and we are looking for an opportunity. So we are just stating what we are looking from an employer and what is our priorities, what we are looking from the employer point of view. But my dear friends, how you will do it? If you take that ownership, what is you're just telling me that we need to bring the change and we need to have a proper balance between personal life, professional life, and we have a good teamwork. How you will do it? How you will act in this?
I think, sir, sincerity is what required the most. So I would be sincere and dedicated completely.
Mm-hmm.
So we must know who is supposed to do what. Everyone should know what.
So goals should be clear.
What is my framework within which we have to work?
Okay.
When I shall feel comfortable during the work, then I can do it, sir.
Okay.
I think appreciation of the work and reward or motivation is also necessary so that we can work well in that new environment. As we are new to that company, we need to understand, and if we are appreciated, then we feel more comfortable and we enjoy doing that work. So it's also a must.
Okay.
And trusting the employers is also very important.
Okay.
Sir, there in my earlier company, there we were a team of 16 people. So if we are working to an end goal, when it is achieved, then it should be celebrated and the proper recognition is given.
Okay. Now we have got some of the action which is coming out from their discussion. You see, when we will get into the new job, we have a lot of desire. Being a new part of the company, we have a lot of desire. We always look at what is in it for me, right? But how we can contribute? When an employer is coming to you and hiring you, your services, what exactly he is looking from you? Where you can contribute is must be understood. As Professor Rao was saying, that the Y generation, simultaneously they can manage multitasking. But what is their priorities? What is their priorities? Today's scenario, today we all know the economy is not so good. Jobs are being cut. Companies are not really very hiring large numbers. They are hiring only critical positions or very, very basic numbers to manage their workforce and manpower cost. That puts you to much bigger challenge, how to make yourself best. That is how Professor Rao has addressed ke how you are investing your time. Are you grooming yourself? Do you know what industry is required? I believe when this institute sends you for the different kind of summer projects or industrial visits, one of the objective is to make you understand what the companies, how they are operating and what they are looking from you. That is the basic objective. Apart from you are learning from that your project, what exactly that systems or that project is given to you is all about. So today is the big gap. I could see when we hire people from the business schools or NIITs, presently we are hiring from NIITs engineers, they have a good, very high desire. Nothing wrong, one should have the great desire, because that makes you more actionable and that puts lot of pressure on you to perform better and better. But only having great desire or a high desire makes you successful? It should be supplemented or supported by right kind of mindset first. Professor Rao has already said so many things which I am using his words. He has said, make your hands dirty. Today when we get into the new job, we always feel that okay, we are from a very good business school or good experience we had. We need to teach people. If we carry this kind of mindset, there's not lot many companies are hiring MBAs. Their major workforce is non-MBAs. And believe me, in today's, I'm telling you the practical experience, when we go to the campus and hire fresh management trainees, we give them the good market salary because we want the best people to work with us. So we give them the market salary. When we give them market salary, what happened to my existing employees? Those are already performing. By hiring a new management trainee, I'm demotivating hundreds of managers. Those are non-MBA and those are working with a lesser salary or equivalent salary with a much higher experience in terms of numbers of years of experience. That puts me in a very difficult situation. And that puts you also in a difficult situation where you need to prove yourself you are better than my old manager. Where will the new employee get under pressure? He could not compete, or he won't get the right kind of guidance and support at that point of time, and then he decide to move on. The easiest way from the life is quit. But let me tell you, friend, if you come across with such situations and you don't fight, you don't struggle, you go to any company, you will find same people, you will find same culture, you will find same issues what they are talking, you will find same solution. But there are lack of education. These are people, those are not executing. There are strategy, but who's going to execute? That makes difference. So that creates lot of thought process on you. Please get into the reality. Today's market reality is we require people, those can come with fresh thoughts and work along with the old employees, win their confidence, still make the difference. It's a big challenge. And this cannot be achieved unless until you prepare yourself. And I'm sure the objective of such in events which is happening in your institute is to just give you the insight, to exchange the knowledge and give you the reality of the industries. So we need to prepare yourself. You need to prepare yourself for all such situations where you will have to compete with the old managers. Still you need to be a different. But two things which again I will emphasize. One is drive for result, which should be very, very high, and that is self-motivation, which you all confess that you are responsible for your own motivation. And I personally believe all other people will demotivate you. Because today is the cutthroat competition. Everybody wants to prove that he is the best or she is the best. In that kind of competitive environment, getting success is a big challenge. For that, you need to have a high drive for result, high motivation, self-motivation, and still a very good willingness to work with people, work with the different situation and success. Though I have some more things to share, but time is not permitting me. I would rather prefer to invest some time if you people have some question on practical experience part of it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Yeah, please.
Sir, what according to you are the three key abilities of a good HR manager?
I believe the HR manager's role is aapne motiyon ki mala dekhi hai. Yes, HR manager ka role hai dhaga. Sare motiyon ko ek saath pirone ka kaam hai dhage ka. Aur main bolta hoon agar HR manager dhage ka role nahi kar sakta hai, he is no right to be in HR.